Good afternoon, RHS. I'm Javari.
And I'm Lauren, and this is your Daily Dose for Monday, April 17th, 2023.
Let's get into the...
Darling, you got to let me know. Should I stay or should I go? If you say that you are mine, I'll be here till the end of time. So you got to let me know. Should I stay or should I go?
Intro.
Wine and Teas has another Flavor of the Month shirt available. The purpose of the design is to spread kindness, so make sure you order yours by April 30th. If you have any questions, see Ms. Comiskey, go to xandtees.com/flavor of the month to order.
Any gamers who might be interested in joining RHS eSports team next school year, the attached QR code will take you to our interest survey. If any students have any questions, please email Mr. Simpson or Mr. Perry.
Seniors, enjoy a celebration in the CRC on Thursday and Friday during lunches. Come enjoy games and prizes with Chris Farrell and the counselors.
Love Mr. Farrell. Spring break was just a few weeks ago, and I went around to see what students and staff did around during their time.
Hey RHS, I'm Jory Watts here with YTV News, and we went around asking students and staff what they did for spring break. Let's get into it.
What'd you do for spring break?
I drove across the state for no reason.
I got my wisdom teeth taken out.
I sit home with Javari Watts, Minnie Carlos, you know, all the boys.
Laid on my couch, Wyandotte, Michigan.
I went to Tennessee for rowing.
I went to the Dominican Republic.
I worked and I house sat.
Absolutely nothing.
I went on a cruise to the Dominican Republic and the Turks and Caicos.
Where'd you go for spring break?
I didn't go nowhere.
Europe.
I went to Cocoa Beach for 2 days, then went on a cruise.
What did you do for spring break?
Nothing.
I went to a geodetics trip to Europe.
We went on a cruise from LA.
We went to Catalina Island.
Ensenada.
And we had a great time and saw some sights.
It was great.
You know, went to Florida with Caden over here, you know what I'm saying? Had a pretty good time.
What I did for spring break, you know, went to Mexico, a little Cancun action, beautiful beaches, beautiful water, got the tan going on. I'm Jory Watts here with YTV News. Now back to you.
Theater students have been hard at work preparing for the spring musical, The Addams Family. The show will open in less than a week on Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. April 20th to the 22nd at 7 p.m. all three nights. Be sure to attend to support this hardworking crew.
You're in the show, Lauren? I didn't even know.
Yeah.
No way, man. You guys check it out. Attention seniors who play football at RHS, there are two scholarships available for you. Isn't that right, Lauren?
Two scholarships. Two of them.
Two for one special right there.
Yeah.
The Alumni Football Club will sponsor scholarships for graduating varsity football players with a minimum of 2.5 GPA who have been admitted into a university, college, or trade school. Interested students must submit an essay along with a letter of recommendation from a coach, teacher, or counselor by May 1st. Also, the G. Knoll Scholarship is available to a current grad who earned at least one varsity award for football while in high school.
You get a varsity award for football?
No, soccer.
Oh, okay. Pick up scholarship information in the athletic office for both scholarships. Now here's Kylie with sports.
Thanks, Lauren. To start, girls soccer had a tournament on Saturday and placed third out of six team. Way to go, girls. Baseball also had a game this Saturday against Monroe, but unfortunately lost 1-0. They have a game today against LP and can hopefully come out with a win. Rowing had their first regatta this Saturday, winning 7 out of 12 races entered, including first place wins in the men's varsity 8 and women's varsity 4. Track also had their first meet this weekend, coming out with wins in the 4x1600 meter race and the sprint medley relay. This Wednesday, baseball has a game away at Edsel Ford. The Unified Athletes will be joining track at their home meet Tuesday. Good luck, Bears. That is all for today. Now back to the anchors.
Attention, seniors. Pay attention. Prom tickets for the Fire and Ice Prom Dance are officially on sale when?
Today.
Your line.
It's today.
Are you going to get yours?
Yeah, it's today.
I think I'm going to wait a couple days. You know what I'm saying?
Like, last minute.
I mean, you might have to.
Just in case a date pops up.
Just in case. You know. They're selling today. Today, through Friday, May 5th. For $70. $70 in Ms. Doyle's office. Guest passes are available until Monday, May 1st. in the front office or LMC. If you have any questions or concerns, please see Mrs. Curdy in the LMC.
Seniors, we are filming the Decision Day video today. This video where our seniors have a chance to share their decisions about their next steps after graduation. Come to the CRC if you haven't come yet so that Carlos can record you telling us your plans. Don't miss a chance to be a part of this.
Have you heard about GeoAddicts? Well, if not, Carlos went to get an inside look at the travel club here at RHS.
What is going on, RHS? I'm news reporter Carlos Morales, and me and Jordan took a deeper look into where GeoAddicts traveled this spring break. Where did you guys travel this year?
We went to Germany, then we went to Poland, Czech Republic, and Hungary.
What was your favorite memory of Europe?
All of it, just seeing the whole different places. It's way different over there. The whole thing was a good experience.
Just like being in the hotel room, laughing with my boys. Like, it was just a fun experience.
Going to a bunch of places through public transport and also playing Uno on the buses and trains with all of my friends.
How is it different than the United States?
The architecture and like the way the buildings looked, everything is different material.
The food, the people, the culture, the money, everything. Everything's way different.
Public transport, it's so easily accessible to everybody, and I think that it's everywhere. Like crossing the street, we had to worry about all of these like buses and stuff and like trains, so it was pretty cool to kind of see that in that aspect and how that was different.
What place had the biggest impact on you?
Definitely Auschwitz. It was just such an emotional and eye-opening trip.
I mean, being at Auschwitz, like, it was just like silent, and like you just learned about how it was like for them people. And like
probably Germany in Berlin, it was really cool over there. It's like New York City but better.
What's one thing that you'll be able to take with you forever?
The whole thing, just like knowing I was over there and being able to experience that was really cool.
Poland, because like I'm from there, you know what I'm saying? That's the hometown, that's where I be at. But finally to go there is just a great experience.
Experience of traveling and also being able to go to all of these different places and kind of respect all of these different cultures and how people do things. I think that is a super important lesson to take away.
Thank you so much.
Is open Monday, Thursday, and Friday after school in the LMC from 3 to 4 p.m. There are teachers there from every core subject to provide extra help if needed.
Teen Task Force is available during lunches on Monday and Wednesday in the LMC. This is a good chance to connect with other students and meet new people. Also on Mondays, the therapy dogs come as well.
Finally, for seniors, if you want a graphic like this made for you, Carlos Morales is heading this project this year. If you received a form in your email to complete so that Carlos has what he needs to make your graphic.
That is all for today. Welcome to a great episode of Daily Dose. You know, like always, have a great day, RHS.
Have a great day, RHS.